Hello and welcome to another edition of the Aussie Ideas, man. I'm doing this one just to show you my injury. I think if I turn this way, you can see this big patch, blood-filled, I don't know what you'd call it, band-aid or something like that, bandage. I'm already umming and ahhing, hate just looking at this laptop screen and I can't even see myself while I do this recording, but in any case, I'm doing this. I think if I put my hand in front, you can see just some blood spots on my hand. But there's a lot worse on my legs, down my right side, in my right arm. I'm wearing my dressing gown early in the morning. I think I'll stay in it all day because I can barely move. What I did was I have a steep hill that I live on. And I had to go down to the bottom of the hill to a bone scan appointment. And I was running a bit late, so I decided I'd jump on the e-bike. As I was halfway down the hill, the folding mechanism, because I was rushing, the folding mechanism came loose and my handlebars just dropped. And my front wheel, with no steering, just twisted on the first little bump and threw me off to the right. It just, this is something that a 70-year-old shouldn't have to do. I consider myself lucky. I almost killed myself. My helmet was on, but it was a bit loose. So as I hit the ground, this is what happened to my head. Luckily, I wasn't concussed. I got up and I kept going to the appointment. And they cleaned me up and put this bandage on. And then I had my appointment. So I got the bone scan done. And then I had to push the bike home because in the crash, the e-bike lost its ability to provide any electric assistance at all. So I had to pedal it. It's still pretty warm this time of year, and I was very sweaty, and everything was a mess. In either case, today I've just am a little more about me personally than what I care about this added guff from the cretin. I'm just using any video to show myself. Now, last night I was sleeping a little, using a lot of painkillers and stuff, but I think I'll ease them off. I don't know how bad I am, but the pain is incredible. My lungs, I can't even breathe in too far without my lungs hurting. And my shoulder itself, I came down heavily on the shoulder, luckily, which probably saved me from cracking my skull well and truly heavily. So my shoulder's taken the brunt of it. And I may have even cracked bones in there. The pain is that severe. I can move my hand slowly, but very difficult to move it in some directions. It just has a complete stabbing pain. I'm going to the doctor on Tuesday, and so I'll leave it till Tuesday to have the doctor look at it and see if there may be more serious bone damage. It's funny, the bone scan didn't cover my shoulder, so just ironic. I'm going for a bone scan, and when I say, "Oh, well, you'll be able to find out if I've done damage," they said, "No, we don't go up as far as the shoulder. We do the hips and legs." Yeah, anyway, that's most of the reason why I'm doing so. So let's just move on and see what I can say about this nonsense. It's the cretin still making excuses when really excuses shouldn't be made.
Hello everyone, it's Steve with Aptera Owners Club. Well, Drift X is over, and as it turns out, the gamma that was shipped over for Drift X did not actually make it to Drift X, which is unfortunate.
Now, it's not just unfortunate. This is another example of how inept they are. I better stop moving my legs about. because I realize my picture is probably going to go off the screen and I don't know where my picture is. This is a big joke right from the start. Gamma was sent to Europe once before and came back. So they had experience in sending or shipping their gamma over. Now Steve Fambro is blaming it on, what is it, Homeland Security or something. Somebody said, I think it was Demagogue, repeated this somewhere and said, yeah, Homeland Security's fault. Steve Fambro has blamed Homeland Security on it. This is absolute nonsense. And even if Homeland Security had some reason to delay it this time around, you'd think something that they've already sent over, they would send over again. And if they were going to be pedantic about delaying it, it would be on the return journey, not on the outbound journey. But in any case, it's nonsense. And this is a lie. So what I'm going to say is this. I'll say it up front. Just like I think they pretended to have a BMW run into them and therefore stop all test rides of Gamma for a good while, they have deliberately held up this Gamma from getting over to the display. I think it would have been an embarrassment more than a benefit. And they figured that out and so decided we'll just have another incident. I think they orchestrate a lot more than what the cretin gives credit for. He just keeps believing their stories no matter what. And no matter how pie in the sky, how absurd, ridiculous, how devoid of logic they are, he just worships these people and thinks they can't lie. Thinks that they just can't lie. They have been shown to have lied and lied and lied through their back teeth for over many, many things. As I say, they're snake oil salesmen. And they're gifted at it. Anyways, let's go a little further. I don't think I'll use the whole video. What I will say is I've read all the first day's comments, and there are a lot of people saying what I'm saying. They're not saying that they've orchestrated it. They don't think that far. But they do say that these people are inept by not getting the Gamma over to an event that it was supposed to be at and that they're passing the buck.
So this was Steve Fambro's Twitter feed, and this says Gamma is almost here in the UAE, but it's about a week late, missing the Drift X show entirely. We have the endless parade of incompetence at the Customs and Border Protection to thank for the numerous delays, Byzantine reformulation of protocol, general indifference, and oh, they're not open on weekends, so cargo doesn't ship out of LAX on Saturday and Sunday unless they've inspected everything. Hey, at least they're busy seizing four counterfeit watches. That is a reference to this post where they were bragging about how they caught four counterfeit watches. But okay, anyways, well done, guys. More to come on this topic. So this is obviously they're tracking the cargo plane here. At the time that he did this, which was April 27, 2024, it was somewhere near about to hit Ireland and Scotland. But it says the good news is we still had our planned meeting, so they still met with some investors, although those investors did not see Gamma and may.
I'll make a point here. The news only extends to the fact that they were able to keep a meeting. Well, whether the Gamma was there or not wouldn't have made any difference. So it's pretty pointless. But what he should be saying is something about the results of the meetings. But once again, you got nothing. Nothing to go on. Just that they had another meeting.
Maybe they came back later to take a look. We have a makeup event at the Formula One track on Yas Island with Gamma and the folks who needed to see it. So that's what went down with that. And so here they looks like what they did is they hooked up with a bunch of influencers. There are no videos from investors, but hopefully they found some big investors because that's really what they needed to do. Someone from the Taco Tuesday said that Chris Anthony was bemoaning the fact that it cost about $45,000 to ship the vehicle over there. So hopefully that was money well spent. I don't.
I'll probably leave it here. I'm really only just showing this. It was a pretty high speed crash. I considered myself lucky for some strange reason. I wasn't even concussed. So even though I'll be in pain for a month because of my age, I'm very lucky. In any case, I will annoy the fanboys and from here just make mention of a few things. The rest of this video goes on to show some people driving Gamma at the racetrack. Now, I'll make a point of this. The guy that only got a passenger ride in it, watch those videos and see if I'm still not blocked, because a lot of that stuff will be relevant information to the manipulation that they get into. You don't see the thing go over 60 miles per hour, and it's not been given as to what reason on a racetrack that it can take at least 200 miles per hour. You are not being given a reason why, but the reason is because the in-wheel motors are very dangerous above that 60 miles per hour, and it's on a very smooth racetrack. If you're on ordinary roads, it's dangerous above 50 miles an hour, I would surmise. The danger speed gets lower the more undulating the road is. It's just common sense. And it's a big fault with in-wheel motors, and they are concealing it. And so, for no reason, they won't go over 60 miles an hour. There's another thing is that I think the 100 miles per hour claim is also excessive. It may even be that 60 mile per hour is the limit that those Wilaffy motors can run at. Their 100 miles per hour is probably not true. It's another claim that is never substantiated, and you've never ever seen one go over 60 miles per hour anywhere in years. I mean, alphas were out 3 years ago, and you've never seen anything go over 60 miles an hour at any time, anywhere. Well, I think that'll do for this time. That's all from me. Bye for now. Stay safe.